वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द डिज़ाइन ऑफ अ सी क्लैम्प टिल द स्क्रू पार्ट. इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल बी डिज़ाइनिंग द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ द सी क्लैम्प. लेट अस कंसिडर द सेकेंड पार्ट, दैट इज नट. द मटीरियल एज वी हैव डिसाइडेड अर्लियर, वी विल यूज फॉस्फर ब्रॉन्ज, द वैल्यूज ऑफ विच आर शोन. द थ्रेड्स ऑफ द नट ऑफ अ सी क्लैम्प इज सब्जेक्टेड टू कॉम्प्रेशन and rotation, that is shear, at the same time. This kind of failure is known as bearing failure. So considering bearing failure of one ring, we have W is equal to pi by 4 DO square minus DC square. This is area of one ring. If there are n number of rings, I will have multiplied by n, and this all will be multiplied by pressure, that is bearing pressure. On substituting the values, I will get the value of N is 2.72, that is approximately equal to 3 tons. Here I have substituted value of PB as 12 because we have used material for screw as steel and nut as bronze. So from PSG 7.87 I got the value of PB as 12 for this combination. After finding out N, we can find out height of the nut H by just multiplying N by pitch. So I will get the height of the nut as 15 mm. Other type of failure of the threads in the nut is the shear failure. So I can write tau is equal to W divided by pi into D0. Pi into D0 is the circumferential area multiplied by T, that is the shearing area. This was the area of one ring. Multiplying it by N, I will get the total shear stress as W divided by pi into D0 multiplied by T multiplied by N. As we know, thickness is equal to P by 2. Substituting all the values, I will get the value of tau as 9.64 MPa. The allowable stress for tau for a nut was 47.5. We got answer as 9.64. Hence, we can say our nut is safe. Next part is the handle. For handle, we know that the torque to be applied will be addition of the total torques. Hence, the total torque applied will be T is equal to TS plus TC, which is 25878.87 Nm, which we have calculated earlier. This torque is also equal to force multiplied by length. Force we were given in the question as 250. On substituting the value, I will get the length of the handle as 120 mm. The last part to be designed is the body. From the figure, we can see that the frame of the body is subjected to two stresses. First is bending stress and second is direct stress or compressive stress. Let us take each of them one by one. First case, that is bending. From basics, we have the relation sigma b is equal to m into y by I, where m is the moment caused by the force, y is the distance from the center to the outermost fiber, I is moment of inertia. Moment is equal to p multiplied by distance. Distance here will be the distance of overhang, that is the distance from the axis of the screw to the axis of the section. Hence, my distance will become 100 plus 2t. If I assume length of overhang as 100, y is the distance from the center of the section to the outermost fiber. Again, from the diagram, we can see that the distance is 2t. Hence, y will become 2t. I is moment of inertia about y axis. Moment of inertia of this I section has been calculated on the right hand side. We got the answer for IYY as 19.33 t raised to 4. Substituting all the values in the above equation, I will get sigma b is equal to 5000 multiplied by 100 plus 2t into 2t divided by 19.33 t raised to 4. Let this be equation A. This equation A gives us the value of the bending stress acting on the body. Now let us compute the direct stresses acting on the body. For direct stress, we have the relation sigma d is equal to W divided by A, where A is area of the section.
From the diagram, we can calculate the area of section as 10t square. Substituting the value, I will get sigma d as 5000 divided by 10t square. As we have selected the material as GCI FG200, the maximum tensile stress acting on the body should not exceed 66.66 MPa. Hence, equating this stresses acting on the body to 66.66, I will get the value of T as 10.02 mm, which I will approximate as 11 mm. Hence, I will get the value of the section, that is 4T, which will be 44 mm. This completes the solution. Thank you.